it, boys. You okay?
Sure, Rob.
Well. Well, there's another picture in the bag. When are you leaving?
Right away.
I'm making my 10th anniversary broadcast from the ranch.
Roy, you can be mighty proud of your 10 years in pictures. You've made millions of friends all over the world.
Hey, Roy, sing Dust, that song you sang in your first picture. You know, we haven't heard that in a long time.
Okay, Joe, I'll remember.
Well, good luck and have a nice trip. We'll all be listening to your broadcast, boy.
Thanks, Paul.
You bet.
Take her easy, boys. We'll see you.
Hello, Roy.
Come on, Roy.
Butter. To think the mighty king would stoop to meet us.
Let's hail the conquering hero, for it's time he did appear.
And with reverence, we proudly say,
long live the king.
He's here. He's written to Rogers, the king of the cowboys, the bravest man upon the silver screen.
Whenever there is trouble, there comes Trigger on the double.
To lick the villain and to steal the scene. He's got away with women, too. How they cuddle up to him.
When the director tells them to.
He's rootin' tootin' Rogers, the king of the cowboys.
The bravest fight to send a fight, the strongest, roughest, and the toughest.
Let me mention, he's a singin' his tune.
Is he the same old Roy that we once knew?
Hi, fellas.
Hello.
Hello, Roy.
Some of you boys take Trigger out of the trailer. Put the car in the garage.
Oh, you might as well saddle him up. We'd like to kind of stretch your legs a little bit.
All right.
Now, go on, go on, go on, go on. Get away. Oh, you can meet Roy Rogers later. Go on, now.
Who was it, Cookie?
Huh? Oh, no. You nobody. Roy, nobody. Well, we sure have missed you around here, too, Roy. You just never know how we... Oh. Roy, that's just some extra help that I hired so cheap I couldn't afford not to, really.
Well, they're certainly well fed.
Yeah, they're great big... Oh. Hello, Mr. Rogers. Cookie promised to introduce us after we took our naps. Didn't you, Cousin Cookie?
Cousin Cookie, huh?
I guess I can't deny him, Roy. It runs in the family. That's Alf, Luke, and Grover Bullfinger.
Cookie, if you don't quit hiring your relatives...
Well, Roy, after their mama died...
We'll never be able to be yours.
I know.
By the way, Cookie, did you ever hire that horse trader I asked you about?
Huh? Oh, well, yeah, you know, Roy, now that's something else I wanted to talk to you about. It was, oh, look at that. There's a little bomb.
Hey, that bus that's been rounding up range horses is over in the north pasture.
Oh,
who is it, Cookie?
Oh, some strangers butchering up them range horses for meat and hides.
That's what happened to the buffalo.
Yeah, but this is legal, and it's written our army contract.
It isn't legal if it's on our range.
We'll better get over and see if there's no double R horses in this bunch. Thanks, cousin.
Yeah,
going on here?
Running wild horses, if it's any of your business.
Get up.
Well, well, I might have known. Roy Rogers, the movie cowboy.
Yeah, get up.
Pretty brave with all your friends backing you up.
Hold it. Stay on your horses. I'll see that this is on the up and up.
Up the drawer you sent me.
All right, but be quiet. That dog barks out.
He won't mind. I promise he won't.
Get him, boy.
Okay, he's had enough, Roy. Come on, get up.
All right, clear out of here.
Anybody can catch wild horses on open range.
Not the way you're doing it.
Well, now go. I got some work to do.
You're not hurt so bad. Come on now, on your feet. Lead the rest of your pals back out on the range. Come on, fella.
Took a licking. That's Roy Rogers and Trigger. I read the movie I'd seen that Roy would sell him for $1 million.
Yeah, I know that. Get on your horse.
Trigger.
Gotta have a little talk with Pop.
A nice lesson in the manly art of self-defense, too.
Where were you?
Just watching. Oh, you were a sucker for those laps.
You see, we can use that money, Jack.
Yeah, now, fellas.
Hey, you're getting awful touchy.
Well, I'm sore. Where were you when I was taking that beating?
Yeah.
If we lose that herd, the hide contract is gone, and so is the money. Oh, take it easy. We're going to do something about it. But what about the horses? We've got to round them up before Rogers gets everybody thinking his way, and they run us out.
Range horses? Well, that's just chicken feed.
What I'm thinking about now is one horse.
Yeah, but Rogers.
Roy Rogers.
And the smartest horse in pictures. Say.
Get that flea-bitten Australian coyote out of here.
Tramp! come here.
Haven't I told you not to come in here when we're busy?
I know, but it's way past lunchtime and I'm hungry.
Here, get yourself something to eat.
Thanks. Come on, Tripp.
Yeah, come back here with Ann. That dog steals everything around here. I can't even find my no sale stamp anymore.
Let me handle this. Told you before, take him out and get rid of him before I do it for you.
But I'll break him up stealing, Lige. He'll learn.
So take him out and get rid of him.
Sure, Lige. Sure.
Between that dog and that stepson of yours, my patience is wearing out.
Now don't worry about him. I'm shipping him off pronto. I hope he didn't hear that crack about Trigger.
Well, Junior, you look nice enough to go to church. Going out of all your clothes.
Help!
You got the place looking good, Cookie.
Help!
Hey, what's up?
She ever seen a movie star?
I can sure tell she's your relation. She weighs a ton.
Oh, she ain't so big.
How old did you say she was?
Well, now, let's see. When I left... I don't rightly remember, Roy.
Well, you know how we tell the ages of horses, don't you?
You mean look at her teeth?
Right.
I can't imagine her being afraid of a mouse. Why, a bullfinch ain't afraid of anything on four legs.
Screaming while I do a little dreaming about my own day.
you guys. You too, Trigger.
Oh, I was winning.
Huh, no wonder you're winning. Trigger standing there telling you what to play.
Ted.
Hi, Tramp.
I came here on a business deal. I'm sorry you caught me this way, Mr. Rogers.
Business deal? Do you generally go around making business deals in one booth?
Oh, no. I just listened to the song when Tramp took it. He's always doing things like that.
What's the matter, son? You hurt yourself?
No, not lately. A horse kicked me 2 years ago. Doc Richard said I needed an operation. Ride said my leg will have to get well by itself.
Where do you live?
Well, right now I've found a place I liked, got a job.
That sounds to me like a hint.
I thought Mr. Rogers might need an assistant. Somebody has to shine his guns.
So that's the business deal. Well, I think maybe we could use another hand and his dog. Thanks, Tramp. That is, if he isn't running away from home. How about it, fellas?
Why, sure.
Who is this Lyons fellow you spoke about?
Well, he's my stepfather. He works for Mr. Jordan down Saddleback, catching wild horses. But he won't mind.
Well, I'll phone down and see what I can find out. In the meantime, how about some chow, Carolyn?
Okay. Ted, you better come along with me. You could stand a little... Well, you know what they say about cleanliness.
Gee, thanks, Mr. Rogers.
Now that you're working for me, just call me Roy.
You call me Ted.
That's a deal.
Come on, Tramp. Maybe we could even find a bone for Tramp.
Works for me.
Yeah.
No, he ain't right now. I'll sure tell him when he comes in. Well, thanks for calling. Goodbye. That kid of yours up to Rogers Ranch, asking for a job.
Well, that's the last time you'll pull that trick. I'll go up and get him and give him a tanner you'll never forget.
Just a minute, Lige. You ain't telling nobody. We want him to get that job. Whether you know it or not, the boy just done us a big favor.
Yeah. Maybe he can help us on that Palomino horse trading deal we're thinking about.
That's right.
Carolyn?
Hi.
Gonna stick around for the big horse race? Who do you think will win? The world's fastest dog or the world's fastest horse?
You better bet on my side, Carolyn. Tramp told me he was ready. Didn't you, Tramp? You can be the official starter, Cousin Cookie.
Sure.
Cousin?
Oh, now, wait a minute, Roy. You can tell by looking at him, he's not one of us. We were bigger than that when we were born. Now, get in there and start the race. Go on. Get on your marks. Get set. Go.
Come on, Trigger! Come on, Tramp! Come on!
boy, Trigger. See, I told you so.
Well, Trigger won, but it was fair and square. I'm not mad at you. Come on, Tramp. Come on, Tramp.
Tramp, that was a good try.
Roy?
Mm-hmm.
You know why Trigger won?
Why?
Because you can holler, come on, louder than I can.
Trigger's legs are a little bit longer, too. How about taking a long ride on the winner?
Hi, Pop.
Roy, boy, how be you? Glad to see you back.
Good to see you, too, Pop. Hi, Ted. Is everything okay?
Sure, Lige. I'm fine. Roy's giving me a job in the ranch.
This is Lige McFarland, the boy's stepdad.
Hi, how are you? That's mighty nice of you, Mr. Rogers. I'm pretty busy, and Ted and I have been bachelors. Sometimes it gets a little out of line, but if you wouldn't be in your way, always room for one more.
You mean I can stay? You're not mad at me for...
Run away? No, no.
There won't be any more running away, will there, Ted? I'll see that he scrubs behind his ears.
You know, that's mighty handsome of you, Miss Carolyn. A woman's influence will probably do the boy a lot of good.
So this is the famous Trigger.
Roy, I won't apologize for that cowpoke of mine slugging that horse. I fired him as soon as I found out about it.
Tram!
Yeah, you thieving mumble, come back here, Roy.
Hey, Pop, please, I'm kidding.
Too bad. Take it easy, Pop.
Why, he's just a puppy. Let him have his fun.
Be a good boy, Ted. Do what Mr. Rogers tells you. There's your stuff.
By the way, you know you're both invited to Roy's anniversary broadcast tonight, don't you?
We'll be there, sure, Miss Caroline. Or bust the cinch. 10 years, huh? Boy, we'll put on a wing day.
It's so pretty, I kind of hate to cut it.
Yes, indeed, ladies and gentlemen. This beautiful anniversary cake here on the table in front of us is too beautiful to cut. But we've got to get on with the proceedings here. So while the guests in the ranch living room are being served this anniversary cake, we're going to call upon Roy to give us one of the songs that helped make him King of the Cowboys. Ladies and gentlemen, Roy Rogers.
Dust in the sky, dust on the trail, dust in my eyes,
dust,
can't see the sun, can't find my way, the dust has won, the cattle and the sheep, better down to sleep, seem to realize their fate. The vultures in the sky know the time is high. Will they fly away or wait?
Oh, Lord, please ease my pain. Oh, Lord, where is your rain? And sunshine,
dust,
must it be, can this be eternity, oh Lord, have mercy on me. Must it be? Can this be eternity? Oh Lord, have mercy on for me.
Well, folks, that kind of brings the
close our little get-together for this evening. So until we meet again, this is Roy Rogers saying goodbye, good luck, and may the good Lord take a liking to you.
Thanks, Roy. We return you now to our main studio.
There he is. Not that way. He'll kick your brains out. Rope that mare and lead her out. He'll follow her. Ted, that's a pretty good-sized piece of cake you got there.
Yeah, you ought to get yourself some.
Yeah, we will. Say, where'd you get that fancy shirt?
Oh, it's Roy's. He loaned it to me for the party. But he says I'll grow into it.
Hey, that looks 50. Let's grab us some, huh?
I bet you Trigger'd like some. Let's go see.
Something to happen to Trigger and your friend Rogers, you're going to keep your little mouth shut. Get that?
Yes, sir.
You just came down here and Trigger was gone. That's all. You never saw anybody, remember?
No, sir. I didn't.
That's a smart boy. If you ever crack one word, I'll shoot your head off. Don't forget that. And that goes for your friend Rogers and Trigger. Don't try and holler for help, because I'll be right outside the door.
Thank you.
search for Trigger is being continued by plane, automobile, and horse, and the sheriff has announced that no stone will be left unturned in the hunt. Although it is feared that Trigger has been stolen and may be held for ransom, no contact has yet been made with the abductors.
They'll be contacted soon enough to let them store their own juice for a while.
Not bad at all for a greenhand, as the seller says that ought to do it. We got Trigger. You can have him back for $100,000. A dead horse is no good to you or me. Have money in small bills. Instructions will follow. Act fast and don't fool around.
Sounds like it, Rose.
Sure, that's the way we want to sound. Might as well bring him in. It's no use in watching any longer. I guess we're safe now.
Hey, one of our boys just pulled out?
Yeah, that was Joe. And he took plenty of grub to the cabin for the boys so they can stand there for a long time without showing themselves.
Trigger okay?
Yeah.
That's good. We don't want nobody coming or going from there any more than we can help. Somebody's had to spot us. Here. See what's left for him.
$100,000? I think that's too much. Why don't we ask for 10 and get it?
That ain't good horse trading. Why ask for a little when you can get a lot?
You ain't getting your cut for thinking.
All right.
I called the studio today, and they've arranged to have the $100,000 here the first thing in the morning. You know, I've got a hunch it's somebody that knows us pretty well. It was such a smooth job, they must have been watching us all the time.
If we had just one clue, if Ted had gotten there a second sooner, he could have had a good look at them.
Yeah. How was the kid?
Not so good. He had quite a scare. He wouldn't go to bed till I told him what was in the ransom note. Then the part about Trigger really upset him.
Maybe I better go have a talk with him. How about a lullaby, Cookie?
Sure.
What's the matter, Ted? Can't sleep?
No, Roy.
I understand. I'm having the same trouble. How are you doing, Tramp? Good boy. Here, let me give you a hand.
Ted, are you sure you told me everything you saw at the barn that night?
Uh-huh. Everything.
What's the matter?
Splinter.
I can fix that. You know, Ted, anything you can remember might give me a clue. You want to get Trigger back, don't you?
Oh, yes, more than anything.
Heard you? Ted, there's boys all over the world who would like to help me right now. But you're the only one who can. If you know anything, anything at all, don't be afraid to tell me.
I will. I want to tell the truth.
Sure you do. If everybody would tell the truth, this would be a much better world to live in. You try to go to sleep.
Sure, Roy.
Don't worry about a thing. They're not worried or they wouldn't be singing.
What's that mean?
It means... It's time.
time you hit the trail to dreamland, little saddle pal. So saddle up your bronc and drift away. It's time you load into the shadows, little saddle pal. Dream about a golden Palomino, taking you to never, never land. Maybe you will find a love lost woman, or capture a rustler band. It's time you hit the trail to dreamland.
I'll turn in and save my strength for tomorrow.
Yeah, me too.
Don't anybody move. Nobody's gonna get hurt. I just want to talk to you.
What about?
I know where Trigger is.
Trigger?
And it won't cost you $100,000 to find out. $10,000's my price.
How can you prove it?
Thought you'd ask that. Take a look at this.
Doesn't necessarily prove anything. A lot of horses have white manes and tails. Where is he?
First, the 10,000.
Okay, you'll get it. But first.
I wonder why they shot him.
Because he was double-crossing.
Double-crossing who?
Wish I knew.
We haven't got a chance of...
Morning, Sheriff.
Morning, John. You're right on time.
You've been sitting here all night?
No, I trust the bars on the window and the burglar alarm.
Well, I guess that $100,000 the vault would buy the place.
Yeah, I guess it would.
Be in the bank for a while. Go and get yourself an ice cream cone.
Thanks, Roy. Come on, Tramp.
Oh, it's you again. Nice tramp, nice tramp.
Howdy, son.
Where's Roy?
Oh, hi, Raj. He just went in the bank. Somebody shot Ed last night up at the ranch.
Well, you don't say.
Yeah. He was just about to tell us where Trigger was. They shot him in the back. You suppose they'll hurt Trigger?
Oh, as long as they get the money, I think the horse will be safe.
If they don't, it'll probably be the end of them.
Well, Roy's in the bank now getting $100,000.
Well, in that case, Ted, you ain't got anything to worry about. Sit on Pappy's knee and I'll tell you all about it. You see, it's like this. Roy goes into the bank. He gets the $100,000. He gives it to these folks. And Trigger's okay.
Sure. That's all they gotta do is give the money to the people that did this. Are they treating you all right up there, Ted?
Sure, Lodge.
Well, that's good. If they don't, you just let me know.
Come on, Tramp.
Beautiful, beautiful.
Hi, Sheriff.
Hello, Roy.
I guess you can see I got the money.
Yeah, the studio
cargo shifted in last night with a special messenger. It's my duty to check up on things like that.
Going someplace?
Mm-hmm. Taxpayers think it's a good idea if I'm along for protection.
Well, I'm a taxpayer, and I think it's a pretty good idea, too. Let's go. Is Pop Jordan selling ice cream cones now?
No, Roy. I wasn't hungry. So I went over to say hello to Pop's wife.
Uh-huh. Well, come on, get in.
This evening, saving it, the moon is shining bright. Birds are fluttering, and the one word is uttered under California stars.
Hi, Carolyn. Yeah, I'm sure missing my big opportunity. I was going to sell Roy a song for his next picture, but Trigger's got me so upset that boots and saddles just sound like a lot of work.
Sounds kind of pretty to me.
Hey, here's something that came in the mail that looks plenty interesting.
It looks just like the other one.
Yeah.
Hi. Hey, Roy. Roy, this just came. I think it's from the same fellas. Well, open it.
Trigger's safe. Follow instructions carefully. Be at Twin Rocks tomorrow and sign up with money. Put in saddlebags, turn horse loose. If you follow, you will be shot, and so will Trigger. Well, at least Trigger's safe. We know what to do.
Yes, if you can believe them.
I'll sure be glad to see that horse again.
You see, Ted, by tomorrow we'll have Trigger back.
I think the money will be safe here till tomorrow, Sheriff. If anything goes wrong, I'll give you a buzz.
If I were you, Roy, I wouldn't bother. Because we're going to forget about this ransom note and not pay the money.
Now, wait a minute, Sheriff. Trigger means more to me than any amount of money.
I'm sorry, Roy, but there's more to this than just getting Trigger back. A man's been murdered, and there may be more. That money stays right where it is. There's still law and order in this county. The apprehension of murderers and blackmailers come first. Can't you see if we let this bunch of outlaws get away with this, it will only serve to encourage them and others to pull the same trick again. No one will be safe.
But these men are dangerous. They'll kill Trigger if they don't get their money.
Yeah, but the money's a...
Shh. Naturally, I'm going to do all I can to prevent that. And I'll need help from all of you.
I think you can count on us.
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I guess I just didn't realize. You know how much Trigger means to me. But if that's the way you want it, that's the way it's got to be. What's your plan?
That's the spirit. Round up your boys and have them meet me here tonight. Now, here's the plan I have in mind. By daylight tomorrow morning, we'll all be staked out in a big circle around Twin Rocks. When Roy turns the horse loose with the fake money, one of us will be able to keep our eye on him at all times without following him and jeopardizing Trigger. Give the horse a good start and follow him at a safe distance. If anything happens, fire a shot and we'll all come running. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
All right, saddle up. Roy, don't forget your little package.
Mm-hmm. Hey, Pat, saddle up for him, will you?
Under California stars, from far across the valley, comes a lonesome cowboy song. He's waiting for the daybreak, when he'll up and move along.
Hi, Roy. See, that package of fake money you asked me to make up is in the drawer. You got time to try a chorus?
Why not?
¶¶
peaceful out tonight. Say, but ain't the moon a shining bright? Robin's in his nest, and the countryside is best, and the California stars. Well, just hear the cricket chime along, and the rattle turning moving by. Shadows come and go while the western breeze blows, and the California stars. From far across the valley comes a lonesome cowboy song. He's waiting for the daybreak when he'll up and move along. We'll see what ain't it peaceful out tonight. Seems like all the world is feeling right. Lord, you will agree, it's the only place to be, under California stars.
Say, that's all right.
Did you really like the song, Roy?
Song? Sure.
Did you like it enough to use it in your next picture?
Well, it wasn't bad.
Oh, gee, then you'll use it. Oh, that's swell.
Wait a minute. Who wrote it?
A relative. A cousin of mine by the name of Bullfincher. Cookie Bullfincher.
I enjoyed that, Roy.
Gee, it was beautiful. You think so, huh?
Oh, yeah.
You're fired.
Oh, Roy, you can't fire me. My cousins won't let you. Besides, what for?
For writing songs on ranch time.
You little tattletale, I'll get you. Roy, honest, I did it on spare time, so help me, I did.
From now on, you'll have a lot of spare time.
Oh.
In Hollywood, writing songs for me.
Oh, Cookie! Cookie, come too. You're going to be famous.
Oh, Hollywood, swimming pool, lights,
and girls.
Yeah.
We better get started.
Oh, yeah. Get a box tacked in. Oh,
my hat, my hat, my hat. Thank you.
down here, same place, and he's got the money.
Should have been here a long time ago. We better get Trigger inside.
I guess we have.
Hey, Thomas, give us a hand. Bring some ropes and the whip.
I thought Rogers was smarter than that, knowing we still got Trigger. But we won't have long, because now they force us to get rid of him.
Hey, what's going on here? Don't do that. Where's the...
Looks like they let you down.
Lige, I guess you was right. Better do your stuff. All right, boys, get your shovels. We've got to bury the evidence.
Ted, you crippled little... How did you get in here?
Nobody's with me, Lige. I'm alone.
Well, how did you know where we were?
I figured when Ed was killed that you had something to do with Trigger. So I followed Pop here.
Ransom money.
A real McCoy. Where'd you get it, kid?
I took it from Roy's desk. I knew you wanted it.
Well, I'll be damned, Bert, if you ain't the smartest youngin' in the whole wide west.
Ed, I knew old Lige's training would show up on you sooner or later. From now on, we're working together. Is that right, boys?
You betcha.
This money's gonna give us a good start.
What about Trigger?
Stay away from him, Ted. He's a killer.
He won't hurt me, Lige. Will you, Trigger? Not too much.
All right, boys, pack up. We're pulling out here.
Well, how did it go?
It didn't. I'm sorry, Roy, but they'll contact us again. They want that money.
Well, at least we still have the money to give them. I sure hate to tell Ted.
That must be in the barn.
Yeah.
So that's where you've been hiding your loot.
Right? a regular thief.
Here's handkerchief.
Somebody's boot. Pop's glove. What this is. Looks like something's been cut out of here. The ransom note.
I don't believe it. Do you, Roy?
It was Pop and Lige who stole Trigger and killed him, all right. Trent must have taken this from Pop's office the day Ted went to visit him. That was the day I picked up the money at the bank.
So now they have Trigger and $100,000.
And the kid's gone. There's no doubt about that. But why did he leave Trent?
I don't know. They were pretty smart, sending a boy here to spy on you. And then when he saw how things were going, skip out with the money.
Tramp seems to think you're wrong, Sheriff.
What are we going to do now?
Wait for another contact. That's all we can do.
We're not waiting for anything, Sheriff.
Tramp, come here.
Tramp, you never left Ted for anything unless you went to steal something. Now go find him for me, will you?
I'll find him.
You sending back to Roy now?
As long as we got the ransom money, why worry about Trigger? We'll just leave him here and they'll find him. We're taking the North Trail.
You said as soon as you got the money that Roy could have Trigger back.
That was yesterday. A lot of things have happened around here since then.
Hey, how about me? I can't move.
Don't worry, Glenn. We'll fix up something to take you down to the doctor's.
Fix up a litter for him, boys.
Okay, fine. All right, Ted.
Hey, fellas, get them horses out of the brush. But never mind the stretcher for Glenn. He won't be needing one.
All right, keep her going.
Well, you're getting to be a hungry young scallywag. What's the matter with you?
Let me go.
Oh, you bring him, Lige.
What do you think you're doing?
Lige, you said you didn't trigger.
Why, of course not.
You mean you didn't?
Why, of course not.
Gee, thanks. But you can't leave Trigger in there and starve.
Don't worry, he won't starve, son.
It's smoke.
Thank you.
wouldn't have done it. I was a bad boy. I took the money so I could get Trigger back. Honest, I did.
I know, Ted. They were popping lines.
Rounded most of them up. Popping lines are still missing.
They took the North Trail. I heard him say so.
Take care of him, Cookie. He's been a brave boy. Well, I'm sure glad to see you, Trigger. We've got to hurry. We've got a date on the North Trail. Too bad a kid like Ted had to get himself mixed up with a no-good guy like you.
Just a minute, young fella.
Huh?
Attaboy, Pop.
Now, Pop, let him have it.
Sure, I'll let him have it. Let him have everything.
Hey,
be back next year.
Yeah. And Ted will be able to walk just as good as anybody. Roy will get the best doctor in the country.
No, you can't agree. It's beyond.